Hello, welcome to Pow Pow Island. I'm Lucky, and today we're going to talk about two things: your island tunes, how to change them, and what they actually mean on your island, what they're used for. And then we're going to talk, and I'm going to show you some demonstrations about how to override the island game music, which is the background stuff which you're hearing right now. Okay, now I'm going to sit down, and as I do, I'd like you to hear the tune that Isabel has in the background when I start talking to her, she talks to me. Okay, so let's go change the island tune. I've already changed it, and I've changed it to this particular theme. So when you first go and sit down, you will see a little grid like this, and it will have different letters. But this is my tune. One more time, shall we? Who doesn't know this tune, right? Disney fan that I am. Okay, we're done. So we're going to exit, and we're not going to talk to her anymore. Now, the purpose of changing this is just for fun. There, I will see if I can link in the description to a couple of sites where you can find great little theme tunes and whatnot. So you heard her using it, and whenever you talk to your villagers or the Tom Nook boys or whatever, that's what's going to happen. They're going to basically have that tune, and you might not necessarily pick it out right away. Like, for example, Sparrow has a bit of a bird voice, and so when he communicates with me, I hear it, but it's faint, and it's a little bit of a different tune. Same with Leaf. We won't even talk to him because it's so faint with him, it's not even noticeable. But where you can, we'll just very quickly visit the Nook brothers, and or the cousins. Are they cousins or brothers or whatever? They're brothers and cousins of Tom, right? Is that how that goes? Yeah. Okay, here we are. Get ready. So you can hear it there as well. All right, so that is all that the island tune does. So we're not going to hang around and do anything here. We're going to exit stage left. And now we're going to talk about game music. So, in a nutshell, the island tune is just a preferential thing. If the one that they have doesn't bother you, hey, no worries, it's all good. But now we're going to talk about the town music. And what happens, it changes throughout the day. Right now, we can't hear it. It's not there. Oh, yay! And why is that? Well, because my stereo is overriding it. Now, so you can make the, is that the high-end stereo there, and there's these wooden box ones. Now, do you have to stand right in front? No. It seems to be a 5-space radius. So once I am in the area, and then it's recognized that we're playing this music here, it's quiet. Now, just as I get close to this last one, I should actually kick this one out of the way because this one doesn't count. Because the stereo counts as one spot in each direction. So now, can you see it's, you can hear there the game music a little bit overriding? So now, how do we fix this or change this? So let's just touch this stereo, and right now I have wandering on, but I have the volume at top, which is here, and you can press the minus and plus at the top of your Joy-Cons. So let's make the volume go up a little bit. We can have it all the way up and watch what happens. Press the B button to go back, it saves it. So when we're very close, it's the loudest. Now watch what happens if I cross over to the other side. You can still hear mine, but now it gets overridden by the game. So how does this play out if you were to look at this from the perspective of having stereo strategically located on your property? So this one is just here temporarily, but I've turned this completely down, so there's very faint music. So I'm hearing a bit of static from my waterfall, which is right here. Now you can hear their music, the game music, but right here I have a little cassette. Now I'm going to actually touch that cassette, and let's turn that volume up again too. See if it helps override better. Okay? So it's still there. It's still quiet. Now we have the same down here. I have a stereo right behind the brick wall, and it's on completely off. So you have to physically have, you have to select the music. Okay, so you physically need, let's just see if we can do this from the side. Sometimes these won't let you change the music unless you're actually touching them from the, yeah. So you have to, so I've got it backwards, right, on this, and same with this little one. If I want to change this, I literally have to pull this and then walk in front of it so that I can actually physically, oops, Daisy. Some of the things we do to set our properties up. So now, here. So this is as high as it can go. And so for some of the smaller ones, I tend to put it up max volume. So we're going to leave that one, that's fine, but this is what I want to show you. So if I move over with the toggle on the left Joy-Con and press A to select, I'm there now, okay? I happen to prefer wandering, so I'm going to select that again. Once I have made all of my choices, you don't select again, you press the B button and you go back. So now everything is set and ready to go. So this little stereo piece can be loud. Oh, let's push that. And then let me sneak up here and put it back into position. Okay, good. It's meant to be right there so I can sneak around. But this is a favorite place where I like to sit. And so I hear their music, and part of the frustration is when I actually come to sit, I actually first go by the music, and then I come around. Now, several interesting things. What do you hear? Pretty much nothing, except for the lovely ocean and the crackling fire. And very faint, you hear my tune in the background. As far as I'm concerned, that's a dream island. So, the trick now is to strategically locate some of your units. And so for me on the beach here now, I've got one here. So if I'm relaxing over here, I still have my. Now it's quite faint, so this one could in fact, we could in fact turn this one right up again. And the reason is because, watch this now, it's high there, but, you see? Ah, I'm just a little too far away. Can you hear their music overriding? Okay. So what does that mean? This stereo, I'm going to make into a small cassette and put it out on the front area. So this one here, really, I can turn that volume right back down, and it can just be for when I'm walking past. But my point of this exercise is to show you that if you strategically, same here, I've got a little stereo cassette on the ground, you can see it down there. I'm using the X button just to toggle it so that you can see. There's the little cassette. So my hopefully this helps you in putting your music, or certainly some of the other albums that you can choose from, strategically. Now momentarily I just stuck this out here because I am moving my aquarium, my museum, and once it's gone then I'll have a setup out here where a stereo will be part of the actual eating area out here. So I hope that lets you understand a little bit. So I have this one turned off as well, okay, so that you're hearing nothing now. Then here, behind this tree, cassette, and behind, well, and beside this one, a cassette. So when I'm in this area, I'm not overwhelmed with their music. Now I might choose to change this stereo in this area. I would need to make a bit of space because I'm missing a little bit of space here, and that's fine, but then I would have music for when I'm seated. So it matters to me that I'm not overwhelmed with their music, and hopefully that's helpful for you. So why don't we just call it a day right here, and look, there's my flag. I custom designed my flag, and so thanks for visiting. I like it here. Just, let's say, a quick run to the dock, because I have a yellow airport, and there's my flag. I love it. These are from my New Leaf days. Anyhow, I'm going to stop there, and we're going to give you some joy and happiness. I hope this was helpful. Leave some thoughts down in the comments. Are you experiencing frustration with the music? I hope this is going to be helpful. Do you have other ideas or tips? And what about the town? The town tunes, are you going to change it? If so, great, have fun with it. In the meantime, thanks for subscribing, for liking, and for engaging in the comment area. Have a great day, everybody. Bye-bye.